In this episode, we're going to be showing you the importance of keeping your device protected against hackers. Don't go anywhere. Hello to you and welcome to The Hive. Now, if this is your first time here, my name is Ryan, and if you want to keep up to date with all things tech, all you need to do is make sure that you hit subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. Now, hacking attacks can happen to anyone on any device and anywhere. And today we are joined by Stuart from Chess. Hello to you. Welcome back. Welcome back to The Hive. Now, hacking attacks, they can happen to anyone, anywhere, on any device. And we're going to touch on one that I'm particularly interested in too, and I think it would affect people in the workplace, possibly, if they're at home. Talk us through kind of the hacking attack that you're going to do today.
Sure, so today we're going to be focusing on unlocked and unattended workstations.
Okay.
And an attack known as a rubber ducky attack, where we take a USB stick with a preloaded script, we plug it into the USB port, and it acts as a keyboard and can type a couple hundred characters a second.
All right, okay. Interesting. So, and it's all done just through on here, all pre-done. So what are the dangers then? How can that USB stick then? What can that do for the attack?
So as soon as we plug it into the laptop, it can present itself to the workstation as a keyboard. And because it's a keyboard, it can type characters. So if a malicious person was to access an unattended and unlocked workstation, they could type the commands in themselves, right? It might take them a bit of time, but they could use a rubber ducky attack, plug it in, have the payload executed within a matter of seconds, unplug it and walk away. But we're going to take it one step further, and we're going to use a wireless rubber ducky attack as well.
Okay.
So to demonstrate this, if we plug the USB stick into the workstation.
So this is now our mock-up. This is just a normal computer at work.
Absolutely that. Right. So someone's, you know, they've gone to collect the post, or they've gone to make me a cup of coffee or something. I've asked them to do that. They've walked away. They've left it unlocked and unattended. So what's going to happen as soon as I plug this in is it's preloaded to execute a payload straight away.
Okay.
The first one is going to be benign. It's just to demonstrate the power of the device.
Right.
So if you plug this in, it picks up. It opens up command prompt, it executes notepad, and it types, never leave your workstation unlocked. Yeah, and that happened within a couple of seconds, and then I can take that out.
Literally seconds.
Away. Yeah.
So now you've done that, can they access anything now? Is that or?
In this particular instance, no. This was just to demonstrate what can be done and how fast it can type.
Wow.
So the next attack we'll do is we'll actually execute something malicious and take full remote control from the Windows 10 machine to the attacker's machine over here.
Yeah, so as you can see, we've got two devices. So we've got this is yours, or what would be the hacker's device.
Yep.
And then this would be the workstation over there.
Absolutely. So what we'll do to set this up is on the workstation is just set up the environment quickly. So all we're looking at here on the left-hand side is I've started a web server in Python that's hosting the malicious payload.
Right.
Right. So this is going to host what I want the Windows 10 machine to download and execute.
Okay.
And on the right-hand side, we're just looking at the interpreter, which is basically a hacking framework used in the industry to what we call catch shells as well. So a shell being remote control of a machine.
Right, okay.
Yeah? So from there I can do things such as open up the command prompt remotely, open up the webcam, you know, steal passwords, look at files on the machine.
Right. Okay. It's crazy to think that you can do that all just from here, and by the end of it, you'll be nowhere near the machine as well, I imagine.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Can do this remotely.
So in this instance, the scenario is now that the workstation's locked. So let's assume that I've got access to an organization. Maybe I've just walked through the front door.
Okay.
Dressed as someone who's supposed to be there. I've brought myself in with confidence. I'm supposed to be there. No one's questioning me. I can't find an unlocked workstation, but I can find a locked, unattended workstation.
Okay.
I can slip the USB stick into the back of the PC so it doesn't look obvious to the user.
Well, I said a lot of businesses still use towers, don't they? Where,
absolutely.
Like, you know yourself that the wires are all hidden at the back.
Indeed.
And but things that I would get missed easily.
Absolutely. You would never know.
Yeah.
Right? You would never know. So when the user attends their workstation again and unlocks it, I just need to socially engineer them to turn away for a little while, because what they're about to see on their screen will only flash up for a few seconds, but it might alert them. So that's quite simple. You know, would you like a cup of coffee? They say yes. I hit the payload on my phone. Magic happens.
And how can that literally just take a couple of seconds?
Does
that attention just need to go away just for 5 seconds?
It depends on the payload you're using. In this particular instance, yeah, I mean, like sort of 4 or 5 seconds, then we should be good.
Wow, right. So Show me what we got going on.
So the scenario is, we've plugged this in, the users, you know, they've come back, they've unlocked, and I've noticed they've unlocked, so I'm going to connect to the USB stick over a wireless signal. So right, when okay. this plugs in, not only does it act as the keyboard, but it broadcasts a wireless signal for me to connect to. And then I can interact with the computer through the USB stick as a keyboard, as a wireless keyboard, right?
So you've got your phone here.
Yep.
So then you're going to, I'm just trying to imagine the scene now. So you've got that, you're in this office environment, you've got that on there. You could literally now be talking to the person you've just been trying to distract, I imagine, can't you? And you're going to take control using your phone.
That's correct. If we see on the screen now, we're just going to connect the wireless signal that's broadcasting.
Right, okay, and that's the one from the USB.
From the USB stick, yeah. Absolutely that. So this is the interface for the USB stick. So okay. I've got things like live input mode, right? So I can quite literally just move the cursors up and down. I can print characters to the screen. Or I can choose a payload. So these are payloads that are preloaded by myself onto the stick, okay. depending on the environment I'm in, because I might have lots of payloads listed on there ready to execute depending on the environment I'm in.
Right? Okay.
So in this instance, we'll execute the Inception demo. So what Inception will do is it will use cert util, which is a Microsoft signed binary,
right.
to download a payload from my attacking machine and then execute a AES encrypted payload that will eventually give me an interpreter shell,
right.
bypassing antivirus.
Well, bypassing antivirus.
Bypassing antivirus. Yeah, any antivirus this will bypass. So don't get me wrong, you still need antivirus, but it's about security in depth, right?
Yeah.
It's about the protection against unknown USB ports.
Yeah, no.
Having device endpoint control, not allowing people to plug in unknown devices into USB ports.
No, you're right. Locking
them down. So let's run the payload. And we can see on the screen here, it gets executed. The window pops up, I've distracted them.
Mm-hmm.
On the right-hand side, we see a HTTP GET request from the victim for the file update.exe, which is my malicious binary.
Right.
Once that's downloaded, the screen will disappear on the left-hand side. And now we can just wait for the reverse shell to come in.
The thing is, with this though, you've been none the wiser. You could literally take them to a break room, couldn't you? Or you could take them away from it for all that to happen, and you wouldn't have a clue all this is happening in the background.
Absolutely. And we can leave this USB stick plugged in there and interrupt that again later on. Remember, this scenario we're demonstrating maybe plugged into the back of a workstation where they can't see it. Or I could just take that away and walk away with it now. It doesn't need to be left in for me to have control of the machine. I've executed something else to give me an out-of-bound remote access to the machine.
Right, okay.
So we see on the right-hand side, we see Interpreter Session 1
yep.
has opened. Let's have a look at sessions and interact with that. So I can do things like drop into a shell. So this is dropping into the Windows command prompt of the remote machine and execute any command I want. Look at files, do ipconfig, whatever I want.
And you're doing this now, and the USB is not even in there now.
Yeah, I could be miles away, right? We might have a what we call a red team engagement where someone's trying to bypass the physical security of a building, might put one of these in, or a Dropbox, and then leaves the premises. That was their job complete. What's happened now is that they've given a pen tester remote access, could be a couple of hundred miles away, access to their environment,
right?
Just by breaching the physical security of the office.
This is crazy to think that now, like you say, you could be hundreds of miles away, but yet you're now remotely jumping in, and you can, I'm assuming you can see anything.
Yeah, anything we want. I mean, we can download files, upload files, we can look at the passwords. I mean, for example, we could have a look to see if there's a webcam on the workstation. We can see there's a HP webcam, so we can do a webcam stream. And open up the webcam from...
Wow.
Yeah.
And does that include the things like the microphone as well? So again, if you're in an office environment with quite sensitive information, can you listen in?
Yeah,
can
absolutely. There's an option to record mic as well. So we can record mic, so for 60 seconds, and I'll start recording the microphone on that workstation and save it to my machine here.
Wow. And I'm amazed that the speed of it, how you can just literally go from plugging it in, you having a quick chat with someone, yeah. pressing something on your phone, and you're in, and it's...
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, 9 times out of 10 on engagement, this will work. I mean, I'll often find at least one workstation that's unlocked, and it just takes one. You're only as secure as your weakest link, right?
Right.
If I've managed to walk into the building and no one's questioned me, it's only going to be a matter of time before I find an unlocked workstation. Yeah, and if it's locked, then yeah, you know, one of these ones will do, and I just need to sit in the car park, connect to this,
and you're done. So what are your kind of advice tips? What's best practice to prevent us against kind of any sort of hacker attack, really? What are your best practices?
It's all about security in depth, and really it's, you know, physical security. You know, challenge people. If they're walking into your environment and if it just doesn't look right, challenge them, right? Mm. Raise that. Endpoint device control, so we're preventing unknown USB sticks being plugged in. Yes, it's emulating as a keyboard and not an external flash drive, but get to know the keyboards that your environment are using. They have a unique identifier for them, right? And maybe you can use a endpoint device control that only allows those types of keyboards to be plugged in. So one of these gets plugged in, it gets blocked.
That's phenomenal. So just literally keep on top of your security. Any questions, anything like that, they can always head over to our website as well. You can head over to chessict.co.uk and have a look. Now, Stuart, as always, it's been a pleasure having you in. Make sure you come back and join us again. But of course, if you want to check out some more content, you can either have a look at the videos that you see on screen right now. And if you haven't already, head over to chessict.co.uk/thehive to check out more from us. Thanks again for joining us. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.